Step inside Coffman Memorial Union. It's at the Center for Connecting with Friends on the University of Minnesota's campus. The building is named after the U's former president, Lotus Coffman. But what's in a name?
What do we want our legacy to be? How do we want to leave this place and understand that students know they're in an area in which they're included and as well as students are welcome here? And part of that comes from acknowledging that past.
A dark past recently revealed through an exhibit called A Campus Divided. That exhibit highlighted university relations during the 1930s. Also, the time of the Great Depression.
I mean, it went over the discriminatory practices from President Coffman choosing to segregate our living situation here on campus for first-year students and not allowing those students, such as black students, to be in the dorms. Jewish students and black students were also being tracked, as well as how that was illegal. Segregation was illegal at the time in Minnesota.
Highlighted past administrators who were discriminatory in their policies. And so those administrators included President Coffman, Dean Nicholson.
For example, the exhibit shows Jews and blacks were counted apart from all other students. Letters like this one went directly to President Coffman, who constantly monitored the number of Jewish and African American students and their housing needs.
I found it extremely disheartening due to the fact that we're striving to be an inclusive campus, and it was really hard to see that in the sense that this was something that had been previously going on and we were not made aware of it.
Another example, Eric Severide, who wrote for the Minnesota Daily, was listed as a radical by President Coffman. He reported on the campus's anti-war movement and later was an award-winning commentator for CBS Evening News. The exhibit's photos, images, and essays led to an uncomfortable truth for many, including junior Chloe Williams and freshman Jael Kirandi.
Coming to a university where our values include diversity and inclusion, this was surprising to me, and I felt that something needed to be done about it.
Williams created a petition to change the name of the building. Tuesday, members of the student body plan to vote on the proposal, which will later be delivered to President Kaler. At the request of President Kaler, Williams and Kirandi are members of a group considering factors that go into renaming university buildings.
We want the removal of Coffman from this building, and we propose that it be changed to a neutral name.
They also want to see the exhibit, which has since been removed, installed permanently on campus.
The university values diversity and inclusion, and so I think that we should parallel our actions with our values, especially on campus, and because the A Campus Divided exhibit highlighted such problematic history, but that's not who we are today.
Adrienne Broaddus, KARE 11 News.